There was heavy deployment downtown Kampala as security forces were surrounding places in the city, and these included City Square, Arua Park, among others. Most entrances into buildings were equipped with police and screening devices at every entrance and exit. At other gates, police dogs were seen patrolling. The business people have highlighted a number of concerns that landlords should address to help in beefing up security. Meanwhile, the heads of taxi drivers in Kampala have visited all parks in Kampala to analyze how they are prepared to fight terrorism. They were led by their chairman, Rashid Sechindi, among others. Leaders inspected different stations and shopkeepers, asking them to be vigilant. Taxi drivers were also educated on how to prevent terrorism. Taxi park chairpersons, including Aloysius Damulira, urged passengers to abide by the rules. According to Sechindi, the visit was aimed at informing drivers and the business community on how to avoid any terror attack. He urged the security agencies to increase the education program for public transport operators. Kampala Police spokesperson Patrick Onyango pointed out various places that should be on high alert of terror attacks.
Eri ku bus park ne ku taxi park nga tutambula n'okubayigiriza babeere buki buli ndala.
Onyango urged Ugandans and the business community to cooperate with law enforcement agencies in their duty to protect them. He asked the residents to inform authorities in case of any suspicious activity. Relatedly, while appearing before the Parliamentary Security Committee, chaired by Nyabushoji MP Wilson Kajwenje, Internal Affairs Minister Major General Kahinda Otafire confirmed that Uganda has intelligence agencies working tirelessly to handle any terrorist attacks.
This is not the first time, and it's not going to be the last time they've done it. Save that this time they've done it and they've made it public for purposes of alerting their own people. So it's incumbent upon us to ensure that, you know, that with that alert, together we had to, with what we already know, because it's not the UK that knows alone, we also have ideas. Together with what we know, that we take measures to ensure that what we fear does not take place.
Otafire praised the UK's warning to Uganda as it showed their love for the country. Minister Otafire warned all Ugandans to be vigilant about their security and also aid security forces who are working tirelessly to prevent any attacks.
They didn't give their alert to me. Yeah, if they put an alert, it's like somebody telling you somebody might invade your house. Be careful. The alert is general, it's generic, you know. It's like, say, I hear somebody saying, I'm going to attack you, and I alert you and say, somebody has intentions of attacking you. Watch out.
On June 17th, 2023, suspected ADF militants attacked Luweha Secondary School in Kasese District and killed over 40 people, including school children. The alert now comes from security agencies after the British government issued a warning against terrorist attacks on their citizens in Uganda or in places of interest to the British. Report compiled by Disan Mutiaba, Wiyondo William and Fred Kajubi for the news.